separate but equal. That was the rationale for decades of degrading, suffocating racial segregation from birth to death, in schools and churches, in housing and hospitals, in hotels and restaurants, even in cemeteries. And it was made constitutional by the United States Supreme Court in the notorious 1896 case, Plessy versus Ferguson. The citizen at the center of that case was named Homer Plessy, a 30-year-old shoemaker from New Orleans. In June 1892, Plessy boarded the whites-only car of a train. When the conductor asked him if he was colored, Plessy, who's said to have been 1/8 black, replied yes.
Louisiana had passed a law, the Separate Car Act, which required that transportation companies provide separate but equal accommodations for Negroes and for whites.
When Plessy refused to move to the colored car, he was arrested as part of a planned effort orchestrated by a group of citizens to use the courts to overturn Jim Crow segregation laws.
Plessy did not win his case, and he continued to appeal it all the way to the Supreme Court. The Supreme Court ruled that separate but equal was legal, that it did not violate the 14th Amendment, and that it was beyond the law to legislate social equality between the races.
Plessy versus Ferguson enshrined separate but equal, and separate but equal becomes kind of the law of the land. And our country becomes an apartheid state really until the beginnings of the civil rights movement and beginning with Brown versus Board of Education that begins to knock down that house of cards.
Separate but equal remained the law of the land for nearly 60 years until another generation of judges on the Supreme Court struck it down unanimously in 1954 in the landmark school desegregation case Brown versus the Board of Education.
Brown versus Board of Education was followed by massive resistance. You had 101 United States congressmen signing a manifesto that they would use all legal means necessary to resist Brown versus Board of Education. And we are continuing to live with the effect of government policies that have never been fully, powerfully, or radically undone.